How's it going in there? Yeah, Jim here. I'm guessing you've been told I'll be tagging along. That is my car you're driving after all. All right, let's get straight into it. Rock on! I'm here because my boys at Motorfest needed the best possible lineup for this gig, and just so happens, I got the greatest models you can ask for in my garage. Here's the drill. I provide, you drive. That's one lap. Don't get shy now. Every car you'll use in this playlist are part of my personal collection. But hey, that's okay. This was my idea, so don't get all nervous about it. These ponies are made for rough handling. No matter how fast and harsh you drive, they can take it. And I've been told, you know your way around cars anyway. No sweat, just go. Whether you're a muscle head or you're just here for the Discovery Tour, it doesn't matter. If you're into cars, you're gonna love this. Just listen to that V8, like a chunky, down-tuned guitar riff. Another lap to go. You got the path memorized? Then punch it! Reminds me of Jackson, Wyoming. I played there a couple of times. You know, feel good, small town kind of vibe, mountain ranges. I know, we're in Hawaii, but the mind wanders. Gotta say, I like the climate here better. That's it, fire it up. Roam wild. That's what this playlist is all about. Drag racing time. Don't overthink, just burn and fly. Right on! Well now, that was some run. A good burn is essential here. Yeah, that was gnarly. Let's do it again. Burn that rubber! chops, like a backup singer in a metal band. Checkpoints on time. It's just like that rad game from the 80s. You digging the soundtrack? It's the spot, right? Mixtape we're listening to. Meshes well with the sound of the engines, you feel me? I couldn't put you through a muscle car ride without some proper riffs, could I? Mustang GT. The thing about muscle cars is it's all about that optimal weight-power ratio, which brings top-notch performance, that sweet spot.
Thank you.
how it's gonna be. All right, let's do this. Monster trucks need monster beats. I've got the perfect hip-hop jewel for this crowd. Obviously won't handle like a regular Mustang GT. Lucky for you, this is a two-lap race. You got one lap to find your footing and one to feed your opponent some dirt. Popped up in the late 70s, mostly just for showboating. They only really became a thing in the 80s. Man, that decade truly was something. You made it through the first lap. Time to crush and destroy. American monster trucks are used in two types of competitions, freestyle stunt and racing. Given Motorfest's racing DNA, we obviously went for the latter. Don't be afraid to use these banked ramps. Ready for takeoff? Yeah! It's a three-lap brawl this time. Don't waver. You can go full speed, through the mud, through water, through the weeds. Ain't nothing gonna stop you. Same goes for these ramps, flat out. All right. Water pond, don't think twice. Mustang jump like the devil is after it. Third and last turn of that swamp cruise. Go for it and don't be afraid to get your wheels dirty. Hold on to your saddle, cowboy. So good. Don't listen to me. Just listen to this and knock some teeth out. Straight line. Use that nitro. Jump, and you're done. Standing ovation. Show's far from over, though.
Thank you.
So the Mustang Shelby GT500 is a bit on the modern side. Let me tell you, these cars have come a long way since their first appearance. Used to call them hot rods back in the 50s when greasers just started putting large displacement engines, called big blocks, in cheaper cars. The tech's evolved a great deal since then, but one thing is for sure, the same thrill that drove people to push boundaries back in the day is what's still driving us now. Eyes on the road! Straight across the roundabout. Don't bother slowing down. Driver friend. That's one lap. Now taunt that giant one more time. badass shot. I'm getting flashbacks of my drives through Arizona. Good bunch of volcanoes there too. And long, winding roads that disappear into the horizon. On the descent, but save some of your nitro for the jump. Now, thrusters on full. And we have liftoff. Time for the killing blow. Right on! Center stage, dude. Hit the lights. That's how you rock the house. Part of the road. Now you can let the supercharged V8 do the talking. Now you probably figured out by now I'm a massive Shelby GT500 fan. Well, you're currently driving my meanest one, my special Jimbo Full Power Edition. That car is one of the highlights of my collection. Calls to me in my sleep, it does. And it doesn't take no for an answer.
Rewind that one.
You're gonna reach the harbor real soon. Quickly closing in on the finish line. Don't you flinch now. That's the power I'm talking about. Final show. Let's get loud. You're driving my number one car, the star of my collection, the 1969 Mustang Boss 429. Name speaks for itself. One of the oldest muscle cars. Still one of the greatest, too, honestly. They had it coming. Mindset had been around since the early 50s. It wasn't until the 60s that the term muscle car popped up, embodying an entire generation's rebellious state of mind. At that time, if you were into muscle cars or just into cars in general, the place to be was Detroit, man. Ever heard of Woodward Avenue? A renowned street for car duels back in the day. We'll be right back. charge. Show them who's the boss. Eyes on the road! Solo, give the audience what they deserve. Muscle car spirit in you.